We have been here for over 49 years. We have produced syrup for at least 46 to 47 years. It was started with the bare bones of used equipment, and we got the itch to do more and more. And each year we expanded. We did over 1,000 buckets by hand, and we processed it in our older building for over 40 years.
We are here at Shattucks Sugarhouse with the Shattuck family in Belchertown, Mass. We have a small beef operation, and they're our local maple sugar producer.
Basically, you know, it's the harvesting of the sap from the trees. In our case, we now, instead of hanging individual buckets, we have a tubing system that we have a vacuum, which brings it right to our RO equipment. It is actually gone through an RO and reduced inside, you know, reduced through the taking out of the water. Our dream was to expand enough for our next generation of family to have the love that we have for preserving the land and producing, you know, maple syrup. I just felt it was time that we moved on to the next decade and make it more efficient and have it for our children and grandchildren.
I went to high school with Nate, the son of Judy Shattuck, and we were talking one day. I let him know that NRCS can assist with their maple sugar operation. I knew they had this new building that they received grants for through MDAR. His mother, Judy, came in and applied for an energy audit, an AgEMP. And the audit identified components of their sugaring operation that would be a large improvements from their prior operation.
We got the building put up with the electrical and the new evaporator. So we kind of combined a whole lot of things. And we made sure that we updated our energy program.
An AgEMP is an agricultural energy management plan, and it identifies any deficiencies. It outlines the cost savings. It estimates cost and energy savings.
NRCS paid for an upgraded RO, which we bought a used one when we started. We said, okay, we've got to learn how to do this. We bought a used unit. And now with the expansion, it allows us to be more efficient, plus the steam hood that goes on the evaporator, which helps with the efficiency of the evaporator itself. And it allows us the next expansion level in our operation to make it more, one, energy efficient, two, be able to produce syrup in a more efficient way.
Here we have a wood-fired evaporator, and the wood reduction so far he's seeing through 1 year of usage on the new evaporator is a 20% reduction in wood usage. Once all the components are installed, I think they're going to see 40%. Trees only grow so fast, and southern New England has been seeing an increase in mortality in sugar maples, so it's more important than ever to manage your sugar bush and your forest land for the health of these trees.
The, you know, NRCS grant has provided us a lot of opportunity to say, hey, we can do this.
And so when somebody walks through the door, you know, we're sure to, you know, do everything we can to help them out. And, you know, to save money, to save wood, to, you know, save time. I think it's important.
The one thing about this building is it's peaceful. You just go in there and it's like, so it was made with a lot of love and hard work and a lot of sweat equity. And we're very pleased that this NRCS grant gave us the opportunity to finish it with equipment that would be more efficient.